Hi, my name is Bianca Lopez, and this is Be in the Know Season 3, brought to you by TAIL. We're all the way in Minsk at Global Entrepreneurship Week, and I have a fabulous woman entrepreneur and a bit of a rebel with me, Simona. Simona is the head of innovation of Welling. So tell us a little bit about how did you get to be that, or where did you start in your career? I like to know the human I'm sitting in front of.
Yeah.
So Simona's Dutch?
Yeah, I'm Dutch, born Dutch. However, I tested my DNA.
Okay.
And it turns out that I have a whole mix of Spanish, 25% Spanish. So now working in Spain, it's kind of funny. We won't
turn into Spanish for the viewers out there, but I'm kind of tempted because she half lives in Barcelona, half lives in Amsterdam.
Yeah.
One of the first things you said to me when we met off camera, you were like, I couldn't do corporate life anymore.
Yeah.
And I had to make a change.
Yeah.
So what was that moment?
I've always been a little bit different than others. So I don't fit in the structure, in the box. And I always made deals with my teachers, like, hey, I know we have to do homework. Tell me what to do in the next month and I will manage. But not like every 2 days you have to do this, because that drove me nuts. So I already was buying flexibility or creating flexibility in my life. So when you work in corporate,
that is very tough situation.
You have job descriptions.
You have KPIs.
Yeah, stuff like that. We got a new CEO appointed. I wrote him an email and I said, hey, just free me up. I'm going to do cool stuff for you. And he said, yeah, let's do that. When you work for an airline, you have airplanes. They need to fly. They should not be on the ground, right?
So yeah, they're one darn expensive thing to be sitting on the ground.
One of the things I did was I reduced the turnaround time of the smallest fleet of KLM with 50 minutes. It was from 50 to 35. And I didn't need any extra money and I implemented it within 3 to 6 months. And it was not my idea, but I worked with people who are actually working in these processes.
You listen to them. Yeah. You empower the people that were frustrated in their current job. You need to weave through the organization.
This is why also I like the human-centered design approach that I have, because we go out there. So I have 5 researchers in my team. They go to the airport, they shadow people, how they behave at the airport, and we identify pains that at headquarters we have no clue. I think this is also the reason why sometimes we don't solve pains or problems that have been around for such a long time, because we don't go to the real root cause. We think we know it.
How do you change that?
Being the boss, say, hey, I have no clue, tell me. I hired you guys because you know better than me.
Modeling by sort of leading by example of saying, I got no clue how to get there.
Yeah, that's the first step. So I started to have my own company last year.
Congratulations, so that's Rebella.
Yeah, that is, and I had to
and
find
I
a
love
name.
The name.
Yeah. And I'm so rebellious that I was like, I want something with Rebel. The funny thing is that I met the CIO of Europe, Chanel, and we started to talk and I told him my company name and he said, I just love that company name. Do you also want to help me? And I said, well, you know what this name means, right? I'm a little bit rebellious, so be prepared. And he said, no, I love that. We need more of that.
So that
this name is also, people should not be surprised what they get when they want to work with me. So it also helps me to say, hey guys, I'm a little bit crazy, but I can also do cool stuff. But I think when you drive innovation, it's also to bring different perspectives.
Yeah.
And I think rebellious people, they have cojones to do things. But they also have to bring different perspectives. And it's not necessarily right what I say, but at least it opens up minds.
Simona, that was really inspiring. I'm kicking off my chair and that doesn't happen all the time. And you're an inspiring force to be reckoned with. Welling and Chanel is lucky to have you, and I hope we get to collaborate with TAIL. So thank you so much for being on the show. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode of Be in the Know, and we'll see you next time.